Hello, I'm Olivier from LiveObjects, and I want to present you a new feature called Custom Pipelines. To follow this session, I assume that you are familiar with Orange LiveObjects. If you are not, please refer to our beginner's video on this channel. Let's start with the core principles for this Custom Pipelines. LiveObjects is a software as a service available from the internet. IoT devices connect to it and publish data. LiveObjects already performs data enrichment with metadata, data decoding by standard decoders, and data decoding by custom decoders. Now, LiveObjects can also perform data decoding, deciphering, filtering, etc. by an external web service. Therefore, your algorithms remain secret, and you are free to build any service with any external tool. Let's see how it works. We have LiveObjects on one side and your web host on the other. Your device publishes a raw message that arrives in the corresponding connector. This frame is sent to the data management block, which will run enrichment and decoding processes on it. Then the frame is sent to your REST web service and the reply is merged to build a rich frame. It can continue its traditional journey into storage, routing, and alarming blocks to finally reach business applications and users. To demonstrate this functionality, I will use an MQTT client called MQTT Spy based on Eclipse PaO. You can find the portable version used in the GitHub written in the video description. Now, let's start. For this demo, I will use this LiveObjects account and I will use this OmaDev device, which is currently offline. I will use an MQTT Spy. I will use this configuration on LiveObjects using MQTT2, which is configured as a JSON device and with my API key, fully secured with my CA certificate. Let's open that connection and switch to it. Right, I am now connected. The purpose of my first demo is to show how to have a ciphering, deciphering process outside of LiveObjects, in order, for example, to keep your secrets in your own infrastructure. So the idea is to have LiveObjects on one side and an external web host here, which is run on this URL. It's a simple PHP web environment. So the frame will be transformed here and sent back to LiveObjects. Let's see how we can have this simple, really showcasing PHP file. This PHP is quite simple. I'm building a random encryption key and an IV. I have those usual padding and unpadding functions. The encryption function, which uses basically OpenSSL encrypt. The decrypt function does the same with OpenSSL decrypt. And finally, my interesting part, which is this PHP file can encrypt data if it's in the payload, and otherwise decrypts if it's in the post payload. So the data is decrypted from the input, and I'm building a new structure called new data here with value and value.deciphered. I'm reusing location from the input data. I'm using the tags from the input data as well. I will set my header to application JSON, of course, and I will encode my data as JSON to the output. Of course, the interesting part is here, the decryption of the value.payload part into decdata, and decdata will be used as value deciphered. So I've simply put this PHP file on a web host, and now we can check if it's working. For that, I'm switching to Postman. So I have prepared here an encryption of some payloads. Let's say that my payload that I want to keep secret is something like that, secret data 42. I publish this GET request, I will have an encrypted payload here. Let's check if it's working the other way around. For that matter, I will check my web service decrypt. My payload here is some standard live object frame. I will insert value payload and I will paste my encrypted payload. Let's send that. Right, my web service answers and gives me my value deciphered secret data 42. I had no location, so location null, and I have the tags copied as expected. So now the idea is to ask LiveObject to perform this web service each time a frame comes in. LiveObjects, data, custom pipelines, add a pipeline. Of course, we enter a name, a description if you want. We'll ask it to run on MQTT incoming messages. We'll add an external transformation. So let's call it deciphering. Enter the URL we had here. I don't need no headers on this one. Let's enable that and complete. Right, my pipeline is active. Let's switch to my MQTT client. Prepare a frame to send to dev data. And as a data block, I've prepared this encrypted payload as before, the location, model, and tags. I put whatever tag here. And let's publish that. Going back to live objects, messages, and let's see what happens here. Look at my value here. Live objects has inserted this deciphered secret data 42. It has kept my payload, which shows that live object keeps the original values that has been set by the device and adds all the new incoming values from the external web service. So the key has been kept secret by the external web service, but I have my deciphered value here. Right, now I will run a second example where I want to use this location part and extend it. And for that matter, we'll consider this live object, a web host running Node-RED, and some government location API. My data will come in, we'll go to Node-RED. Node-RED will run a request on the government location search API. We'll insert the results back in the frame. And boom, it goes back to LiveObject and finishes its journey. Here is my Node-RED flow. It has an HTTP endpoint acting as a post, reacting on geo-enrich path. My next part is to isolate the payload from my message, put it in message request. Then calling the government API, I will use my lat as request location lat and long as request location long, mustache formatting. Then merge and tags, I will use the answer from the government API here as message payload features 0 properties label. This is how the government API answers. I will put that in message request value geo that I will reuse right after. I'm building a new payload that will be answered. So my payload is a dictionary. I'm putting the value as what I've set here. I'm setting the location as before and I decide here not to reuse the previous tags, but to build a new tags. So of course I could change this line to reuse my previous tags, and I'm pushing two tags enriched and pipelined, whatever. And building this answer frame that will be given as a response with status code 200. So let's test this API with Postman. So I'm calling the API geoenrich here. My body will be just like what a live object would send, with location, some value, and some tags. Let's send that. My value has kept the air quality and has been added a geo tag with some real address corresponding to this location. So the location has been kept and tags. My external sensor tag has been removed as expected, and my two other tags has been added. So this is my external API. Let's see now how I can add this to live objects. So let's go back to live objects and custom pipelines. I will edit my demo pipeline and we'll add a transformation. So named geoenrich, setting the URL. Again, and I have no headers, there's no authentication on those APIs. And save that. Right, I will come back to MQTT and republish that frame. Let's come back to messages. Look here, I have a frame that is right now. I can already see that my tags have been changed, my value ciphered has been removed, and my two new tags have been set. Let's open the value details and check here. Now I have value, geo, and some physical address corresponding to my location here. I still have my deciphered secret data, so I can see that my pipeline has run through the two web services and my original payload. So my value part has been stacked with the original and the two payloads part. The tags have been replaced by the two new tags set by my Node-RED. So I have my complete setup now running physical address enrichment, some external deciphering, and all of that running on external servers completely outside of live objects. Further options are available. You can find them all in the developer guide. The URL is in the video description. You are now ready to develop your first custom pipelines inside live objects. And see you for the next episode. Orange.